Sims, turn it back. Get the fuck out of it.
Ever seen PK Subban play hockey? Pretty great, right? Will I catch up to love? I can never tell. The NHL has always been a very diverse sport because it is supported by 43 countries. However, it is not very diverse in the sense of colors. The NFL has 68% of players are African American. In the NBA, there are 75% African Americans. But in the NHL, there are only 4%. So it is amazing that PK Subban plays with a low percentage of African Americans. PK Subban might not have been able to play if it wasn't for a great human being. Intro to Willie O Ree. He was born in 1935 in Frederickson, New Brunswick, a time where race relations in the U.S. were at the height of conflict. Lucky for him, he was born in a place where there wasn't as much prejudice as the U.S. Here's a little background info on the town he grew up in. Willie O Ree grew up in the small town of Frederickson, New Brunswick. Rumor says that sometimes he would even ice skate to school. Frederickson has also graduated many other NHL players, such as Jake Allen and Danny Grant. Here is a quick timeline of racial events leading up to his debut in 1958. Even in the 1950s, colored people weren't allowed to sit in the same seats or drink the same water as white. Also, there were the brutal Detroit riots, which my great-grandpa was a policeman. He put his 14-year-old son on the roof and said, "If any Negroes come in this yard, you shoot them." Jackie Robinson made his debut in 1947 as the first African-American baseball player. Willie later got to meet him on a field trip with his baseball team. Jackie asked Willie what he wanted to be when he grew up, and Willie said, "A pro hockey player." Jackie responded by saying, "Son, Negroes don't play hockey." Willie wanted to prove him wrong. Martin Luther King's famous
"I have a dream"
speech was in 1963, a few years after Willie started playing with the pros. This interview from CBS shows how much racism Willie O Ree had to go through to make it to the pro leagues.
It happened in Chicago, 1961, my first trip into Chicago. We're playing against the Blackhawks. I'm skating around and I hear some, you know, racial slurs, but it goes going in one ear. Well, anyway, I get into an altercation with one of the players, a big right winger. His name was Eric Nesterenko, big, tall right winger. Well, anyway, the puck can have a shot on the net and I go in and he comes on my blind side. I can't see him. I go in around the net and as I turn, he takes a stick and he butt-ends me in the mouth and splits my nose, knocked my two front teeth out, split my lip here, and my teeth fall down on the ice. And he made a couple of racial remarks at me, but it wasn't the racial remarks that set me off. He kind of stood there and was kind of smiling like, what are you going to do? Well, I hit him over the head with my stick and then all hell broke loose. We, both benches emptied. We were both thrown out of the game. I had to remain in the dressing room the entire game. This happened about 5-6 minutes into the first period. Coach Milt Schmidt said, "Willie," he says, I'm fearful for your bodily injury on you." He says, "You've got to stay in the dressing room." Well, once they stitched me up and plugged my nose and everything, at least I wanted to come back out and sit on the bench with the team. But he says no. So they had two police officers outside the dressing room, and I'm pacing back and forth in the room. So I turned the lights out in the dressing room and I sat down in the dressing room in the dark, and I just said to myself, "You don't need this, Willie. You could go back home, you could play in your hometown. You if you're going to be exposed to this every game, it's just not worth it." So I sat there for about 6 minutes, and then I turned the lights back on and I said, "No." I says, "If I'm going to leave the league, I'm going to leave it because I don't have the skills and the ability to play anymore. I'm not going to leave it because somebody is trying to, run me out of the league." And I says, "If I have to fight, I'm going to fight. But I'm going to fight in regards to the game. I'm not going to fight because of racial remarks."
When Willie O Ree was just 19, he suffered a major injury. A puck bounced off a post and hit him in the right eye. He collapsed to the ice in pain. He lost all sight in his right eye. This is a common injury in hockey. let's go over a quick timeline of Willie O Ree's career. The first team he played for was the Boston Bruins. He only played 2 years for the Bruins. In the 1960 to 1961 season, he scored his first NHL goal. In that season, he had 4 goals altogether. The next year, he was traded to the Montreal Canadiens. He thought he might not see the ice much because they had so many superstars. But good thing he was traded to the San Diego Gulls 2 months later. San Diego is where he lives to this day. A few problems that Willie had was that other players would get paid twice as much salary as Willie, and people would yell racial remarks and toss cotton balls on the ice. Willie also broke a lot of things through his career, including eye damage, broken ribs, thumbs, both knees took damage, and dislocated his shoulder. When Willie retired in 1979, the National Hockey League asked him if he wanted to be the youth director. Willie said yes. His main goal was to get inner-city kids into hockey, but his main problem was that he couldn't get ice time in the city because it was so expensive. In conclusion, Willie is a great human being. He broke the color barrier into hockey in 1958, which is crazy because still today there is only 4% African Americans in 2017 with no racism. O Ree opened up the sport to many players like P.K. Subban. When he retired, he helped tons of people get into hockey. Willie is an inspiration to all.